excitement, wondering who will be the next Miss America.
Miss America is a sex symbol.
Big boobs,
nice calves, good thighs.
It improves their poise, their personality. It does a lot for their self-esteem.
They really show how smart they are sometimes with the questions they ask, and they have nice bodies, some of them.
I don't really think that just because you're good looking, you have to be stupid.
There's so many benefits. There's a scholarship.
I have seen it as an opportunity to better oneself.
Surfing through the channels there, I always stop and take a good look,
because I like pretty women and I like to see them in a swimsuit.
She's sort of like the all-American girl.
I think it's really representative of some of the best qualities that women have in our country.
It's almost that time. Just 1 week from tonight, the 74th Miss America will be crowned. Good evening, I'm Ann Jillian. Many of the participants in the Miss America program first compete on a stage just like this in their local pageant. It's the first step in a long journey that concludes at Convention Hall in Atlantic City. The broadcast of the Miss America pageant is one of the largest annual live TV events of the year. For a lot of you, that's what Miss America is. 2 hours of primetime TV entertainment capped by the exciting moment when they announce the winner. For you at home, the crowning is the end of the pageant. For Miss America, it's only the beginning. Tonight, we will go beyond the crown and meet the people who know the real Miss America and learn how she helped to change their lives. Ah, sure. I know. Some of you may think Miss America, big hair, nothing upstairs. Well, think again. Miss America participants have conquered the Great Wall of China and organized a demonstration against their own pageant. They brought the bathing suit industry to its knees and turned their private ordeals into public crusades. Miss America's face has graced the covers of magazines, and the rest of her has been revealed inside them. Miss America was once only known for her glamorous legs, but later she proved they could go the distance. Miss Americas have made a strong impact as individuals, and they have often been ahead of their time, although it is hard to tell from the questions they were once asked.
Do you like Bermuda shorts on men? Do you think it is proper for a lady to propose marriage in our modern day? Do you like a young man very much? You find the scent of his hair tonic offensive. You are walking down the runway in swimsuit competition, and the heel of your shoe breaks off. What would you do?
Well, I think it's far more natural to walk barefoot in a swimsuit. Well, I just kick the other one off and walk that way.
Do you think that you could successfully pursue a career and still maintain your responsibilities to your husband and family?
Yes, I do.
I intend to use my education to become a probation officer and to one day operate a facility for the socially handicapped.
You hear me? What's your platform?
Platform is increasing awareness and funding for breast cancer research.
What would you do to foster citizen involvement in our political system?
I would implement a program called Student Assistance Programs.
What do you think about employers requiring workers to undergo mandatory drug testing?
It's vital that we get out there and vote.
What conditions do you think makes the time right for a girl to marry?
Heaven only knows.
When we come back, you'll discover that there's life after Miss America, and some of it will shock and surprise you. And by the way, at each commercial break, you'll get a sneak preview of next Saturday's Miss America participants.
Miss America Beyond the Crown, sponsored in part by New Secret Ultra Dry. Strong enough for a man, but now with ultra dryness for a woman.
What's inside this new, extraordinary kind of antiperspirant provides the most effective dryness.
Co-ed who thought she bulged in the wrong places. The judges didn't think so.
It was strictly measurements. And hopefully you are articulate. The judges didn't care whether or not you knew anything. Just wanted beauty in those days. They probably just thought I had the best looking legs in the show. She got legs.
In the early days, great-looking legs were what you were judged on. But anybody with enough ambition to enter the Miss America pageant has always had something extra going for her beyond basic anatomy. The reason outer beauty was the focus in 1921 is because the whole pageant started as a PR gimmick.
When the bathing beauty was a new institution, the fashions were different, but the girls were frisky and gay. At Atlantic City, they gather from everywhere to compete for the crown of Miss America.
Oh, the dash of it, the youthful spirit, the utter bravado, like fairy queens with parasols or magic wands. How proudly they model their own ideas of what a bathing costume should be.
Robert, can you spell a
time? Sure, there wasn't any money around. It was a very bleak time. They were sick and tired of hearing people jumping out of windows and committing suicide. But it was so nice to be able to read something about a typical American girl, a girl becoming a Miss America. It came at a very, psychologically, a very, very good time. It was very needed. There was a little bit of glamour, too, because that was the time when we needed glamour.
Today's Miss America is still glamorous, but she's chosen more for her brains than her bod. However, 1942's Jo Carroll Dennison swears she owes her crown to her footwear.
I asked the judges, you know, how come you picked me? And he said, it was those black suede shoes. I had huge black platform shoes. And he said, we just love them. And I wore them with everything, with my evening gown, with my bathing suit, with my sport clothes. I love those shoes.
The town of Berlin, when the Yanks go marching in.
In 1942, our country was at war, and Miss America became more than a gal flashing her gams. She was an important symbol to the soldiers shipping off to distant shores.
It was 50 years ago, right here in L.A., and I was being inducted into the Navy, and she came, and she walked out in front of us. I thought, my Lord, this is the prettiest woman I ever seen in my life.
They came, they applauded, they smiled in a way that I had never experienced before.
She was a guest of honor and gave us a very lovely speech, one that I'll never forget. And I stood within just a couple feet of her, and I'll never forget that. And then that evening, they put us on a train and sent us to Farragut, Idaho. And that's all we talked about was Jo Carroll Dennison, Miss America.
It was their country that they were applauding. And they were going out, they were willing to go and die for their country. So it was an awesome experience.
In 1989, my wife passed away. And so my daughter, Karen, she knew I was feeling pretty low.
It was a very hard time for both of us. We were both very close with my mom. And this just seemed like an opportunity because of her name being mentioned enough times that now I was familiar with her name.
One day, a young woman called me and said, my father saw you. It's something he's always talked about. He's always said that in his life, one of the big thrills was that he got to see Miss America when he was inducted, and would it be possible for him to meet with you? And I said, well, I'd be tickled pink. I'd love it.
Oh, it was heartwarming. It was really something. I'd look back and I'd picture her standing there in front of me and how beautiful she was, and she hadn't changed much either.
I'll be seeing you in all the old familiar places.
Just all the grief and pain he had been through up to this point wasn't there. Wasn't there now. He had something that made him happy. And, you know, here it's 5 years later, and he still is thanking me for calling him, because that's how much it meant to him.
As World War II progressed, the role of women began to change. Because of this, the pageant began to change.
When I began to go into the defense plants, women were in those factories. Women were in the defense plants for the first time, really, in our country's history. In 1994, that kind of Eleanor Roosevelt attitude is predominant in the pageant. And in the country, I think that in a way that the pageant kind of led. More and more they were going for the person and who it is rather than the figure and the measurement.
By the mid-40s, filling out a college application was more important than filling out a swimsuit. Miss America was moving in a direction that would change her image forever.
In 70 years, Run Raisin Roses have been the tradition. But when will you see the new Miss America pageant? Join hosts Regis and Kathy Lee, special guest Kenny Rogers, and the most extraordinary women of the 90s. The Miss America pageant is live next Saturday at an earlier time, 9, 8 Central on NBC.
World War II marked a new beginning for Miss America.
Yes, forbidden beauty is still ruler of all she surveys in the USA.
Such dazzling beauty, and so much of it that words are hardly adequate.
What's your hurry, sis? Stick around.
Puerto Rico's pretty. I could write a ditty. But man, my brow, this showing up is a southern treat. Say, these corn-fed cuties are going to be hard to beat.
In 1945, one woman's determination helped change the image and opportunities of the Miss America pageant. For 32 years, Lenora Slatter was the director of the Miss America pageant, and one of her first contributions was to make education a priority.
I tried to see to it to the best of my ability that every girl in America who wanted to go to college, sincerely interested, could find a way to go. I felt that the scholarship program would encourage many of them and make it possible for many. Because girls didn't end up thinking they were the prettiest things in America. They knew they were just ordinary, good-looking American girls. But they wanted those scholarships.
The first young woman who received the scholarship became one of the most famous Miss Americas of all time. Bess Meyerson was Miss New York City and the first recipient of a $5,000 scholarship. The selection of Bess had a tremendous impact on many people because she was also the first Jewish Miss America. In 1945, with the end of World War II and the liberation of the prison camps in Germany, crowning a young Jewish woman as Miss America became a symbol of universal acceptance.
We were very jubilant that she won because I was comparing it with the sentiment of Europe and that this truly is a free country. She was the first victim that we saw with our own eyes that Jews can succeed here. I think the Jewish community embraced her, and they had a heroine representing the Jewish people are also beautiful, Jewish people are also talented.
Long after her reign, Bess continued to promote religious tolerance. She was the first representative of the changing face of Miss America, but she definitely was not the last.
I wasn't 5'9". I'm not blonde. I don't have blue eyes. I was not the stereotypical Miss America.
I grew up, of course, watching the Miss America pageant faithfully every single year and never saw anyone who looked like me.
And even my sister, she told me, she says, "Debbie, they're not going to let you have it. And even if they did, you have to work 110% to be considered as good as another Caucasian person's 90%.
For years, a little African-American girl growing up in America might have wondered, can I win a scholarship too? Over the last two decades, the pageant has changed dramatically, and African-American winners and contestants are taking the new pageant story back to the neighborhoods.
Listen, I'm no different than you are, and I learned that any goal I set for myself, I could achieve with hard work, and I'm not special, so if I can do it, so can you. During my appearances, I ran into many young people and got really wonderful, encouraging letters, not from just little black girls, but also little white girls, and Judy does come in all different colors and shades and ethnic backgrounds.
And the news, Miss America, Kimberly Clarice Aiken, Miss South Carolina.
But I think everyone was proud to know that we had moved forward finally, and that the definition of beauty had finally been broadened, and not just physical beauty, but inner beauty.
Three African-American Miss Americas in 5 years. Five in a decade. But it wasn't too many years ago that the faces of Miss America were not so colorful. The pageant can be as much a prisoner of its times as a leader.
I could relate to my grandmother. They watched the Miss America pageant from the time that it was televised in the 50s. I always watched the pageant and saw Miss America crowned, but never, never dreamed that their granddaughter could be Miss America.
Dreams of the crown. That was just not possible for many, many years. Other barriers had to come down first. And there was Rule 7. Contestants must be in good health and of the white race. It was quietly dropped in 1950, only to be replaced by a more subtle barrier.
It was unheard of in the 50s to have blacks in the contest, and I was extremely vocal about that.
Miss America 1950, Yolande Beck-Bees, took on the race issue with a fiery intensity that proved too hot for many to handle.
It was very difficult, but I knew I was right. Can't have that just a white show. There were so many of us that stood up and to be counted with that. There were many very vocal and fine, outspoken Miss Americas.
But change came slowly. Frustrated African Americans set up their own contest in 1968. That woke up the pageant. In 1970, Iowa crowned Sherrod Brown, but the real breakthrough came 10 years later.
I knew a woman with a diamond ring.
It was the first time it ever happened in history where two blacks, first of all, were entered at the same time, and two blacks also won preliminaries. We happened to win preliminaries on the same night, which was, I think, the first time maybe that America thought, wow, a black woman could actually become Miss America.
And our new Miss America is Vanessa Williams, Miss New York.
The wonderful thing about Vanessa finally winning was it caused a whole group of people to dare to dream when they had dared not dream before for fear of being disappointed.
I think about all the young women, African American and minority women, who dream and who have dreamt of not just being Miss America, but of doing all the things in their life that they've always wanted to do. And a lot of barriers and a lot of doors have always been closed in our faces because of it, simply because of the color of our skin. And I'm just really proud to be able to say that I helped to knock down that barrier.
The 50s was a confusing time for the modern woman. For many, it was a return to home life with its own challenges, and they couldn't be happier. But others were striking out on their own, and no one better symbolized these contrasting times than the decade's first Miss America, a striking Alabama belle, Yolande Beck-Bees.
I'm Southern.
I'm a Southern girl. We learned to say no. I won the bathing suit competition in these funny high heel shoes with ankle straps a la Joan Crawford, tottering around. It was most uncomfortable, most uncomfortable.
The winner is named. She's Yolanda Beth Dees of Mobile, Alabama.
After winning it, the swimsuit people informed me that I was to go on a series, three separate tours of traipsing around in the winter in high-heeled shoes and a bathing suit. So I simply said it was out of the question. And it truly was. It was out of the question for me.
The swimsuit company pulled its sponsorship after Yolande put down her spiked heel. The pageant was quietly thrilled. After all, it was a scholarship contest.
When I refused to pose in a bathing suit with a sponsor, they started their own contest, the Miss Universe and the Miss USA, and which is truly a beauty contest. We're not a beauty contest. We're a scholarship contest or a scholarship foundation.
Yolande was a firebrand in an era when only father knew best. We had plutonium bombs and platinum bombshells, and gentlemen preferred blondes wearing pearls in the kitchen. For many a young woman, being Miss America meant hiding her individuality to become an untouchable ideal.
Is Tommy taking you to the school prom?
This is the most exciting day I and my family have ever had.
The happiest moment of my life. It's a dream every mother has.
Oh, she's been a lovely gal all her life.
Barbie's small and so petite. Her clothes and figure look so neat.
She likes men for their brains. And so she'd even marry a midget if he were a mental giant.
Ooh, ooh.
Be pretty and to be talented too. Now there is the combination.
Miss America, Miss Colorado!
Marilyn Vandiver looked like the All-American girl when she won the 1958 pageant.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, here is a perfectly wonderful American family with a perfectly...
I feel a deep sense of sadness when I watch that.
And needless to say, the proud father.
It would have been inconceivable to have seen the terror that I felt inside. There is no higher that you can go in the 1950s than Miss America. And there is no one dirtier or uglier or more unacceptable than an incest survivor. Two Marilyns left Atlantic City for home in Denver. The public Miss America profiled by Edward R. Murrow.
Good evening, Miss America.
And the private Marilyn hiding her terrible, terrible secret.
We're gathered together in our game room. I'd like to have you meet the vile woman in my life.
There was no doubt in my mind that if people knew I was an incest survivor, people would look at me with revulsion. Marilyn went on to become one of the most successful Miss Americas ever, even hosting a few pageants. But she agonized in silence until just 3 years ago. She was an incest victim from age 5 to age 18. Today I stand before you at age 54, an incest survivor.
Named Outstanding Woman Speaker in America, former Miss America, now committed to helping adults who have been sexually violated as children.
To have one of their outstanding Miss Americas, and I was an incest survivor, that just had to have been difficult for them. But they have been supportive, very supportive. There is nothing depressing at all to me about walking into a meeting with 1,000 people who have their heads down and are living in shame and they're crying, because I know I can give them a gift.
Marilyn's disclosure, the public disclosure in 91, had a profound effect upon me. I just was amazed at her courage. This clip was played over and over again on television, as well as some of the text of her speech being in the newspaper. And I would clip those things from the newspaper and cry over them. And crying for the grieving for the lost years, the distorted years of not only myself, of course, but the terrible 13 years that Marilyn spent. I wanted to be rid of the shame that I felt, and I wanted to stand as proud as Marilyn was standing there. And I guess maybe that's what I'm doing now. I look at Marilyn as a symbol of all that's right, and the reason I guess there should be Miss America pageants is so that people can come forward and do some good.
There is a power in having been a Miss America. And to be able to use that power for what I consider to be a much higher purpose is the gift I was given.
Many women began speaking up and speaking out during the turbulent 60s, rapidly leaving some old stereotypes behind.
Of course, these days, we're seeing a magical change in girls all over America.
I have a dream.
If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning.
Today, there is a great state of tension.
You move.
I want to hear women's liberation now. In 1968, women's livers were taken to the streets and to the boardwalk. Ironically, one of the planners of the pageant protest was none other than Miss America 1950, the intriguing and outspoken Yolande Bette Bees.
It was the bra burning, the notorious bra burning. I was criticized for my beliefs, but I'm used to that. I've been criticized for being, some people say, ahead of my time with the women's movement. It worked. It got us a lot of attention for good things and to affect change. And the Miss America contest did change.
Live from Convention Hall in Atlantic City.
Little did the demonstrators realize that the ladies in Convention Hall were breaking down barriers too.
The sport of gymnastics offers young women the opportunity to develop physical fitness and grace. Judy Ford, Miss Illinois.
I wanted to compete in sports and athletics. I really wanted to be the world trampoline champion. The women's movement and the Miss America pageant goals and aims are basically the same. To help young women to realize their full potential. I was very proud to be someone who could maybe have a part in changing people's stereotypical images. You can be a woman, you can be feminine, you can also do all other things.
It's America! It's Illinois!
Judy went on to become the first woman member of the President's Council on Physical Fitness. Later, she became a coach and joined a host of emerging female athletes to blaze new trails for young women. That's the legacy of Miss America for many young girls, like 12-year-old Kylene Barker, an aspiring gymnast, who was glued to her TV that Saturday night back in 1968.
Well, I was sitting there with my mother watching the annual Miss America pageant. All of a sudden, the stage just became alive for me. And the reason it came alive was because she was a gymnast. And she wasn't up on a pedestal like a lot of people put Miss America as. They think, oh, she's like Cinderella. She's not real. She wears that crown and she lives in a castle. But Judith was real to me. She was a real person because she was doing what I wanted to do.
Miss Illinois is Miss America.
That moment, right then and there, right after she won that crown, I jumped up and started practicing because I said to myself, if she can do it, I can do it.
Kylene Barker, Miss Virginia.
I think that probably our Miss Americas in some way are role models for that one little girl or two little girls sitting out there in TV land watching the Miss America pageant.
Our new Miss America 1979, Eileen Barker, Miss Virginia!
Miss Americas can change people's lives.
You know, you affect a lot of people's lives that you really don't realize at the time. That, you know, someone looks at you and says, gee, you know, she can do that, so can I.
Making a beautiful body takes a little doing. Making a beautiful hairdo takes a little dippity-do.
Now let's forget all about inflation, the energy crisis, and anything else that's been bugging
you. All Americans are to be evacuated immediately.
A plan to enter graduate school, securing a Master of Arts degree.
The actions of Iran have shocked the civilized world.
Just so now.
Miss America Scholarship is now total over $2 million every year.
The 70s into the 80s brought rapid changes for women. The media was still fixated on Miss America's bottom, but Miss America was more interested in the bottom line.
I needed the money to go to law school, and so I entered the program, and I told them flat out, I'm here for the money.
Even commercial America gave her a little green card to go with that attitude.
With this, they realize there's a lot more to Miss America than just a pretty face. I don't think I really was a rebel. I think I was a woman of the 70s. And I think the Miss America pageant was ready for that.
When I was in college, I don't think I knew any women lawyers at all.
Rebecca Ann King, Miss Colorado.
She was a year ahead of me in school. I remember her in the pageant actually saying, I want to be a lawyer and a judge.
Through the practice of law, I hope to make a productive contribution to mankind and find the happiness of a fulfilled woman.
She was different than the other Miss Americas that I've ever known, in that she did have that career goal as part of her. It wasn't just to be Miss America, it was what she was going to do after. And I was very glad when she actually did go to law school and fulfilled that.
I felt when I was traveling, every day, that people would look at me and say, oh, she's just another Barbie doll. Empty-headed bimbo, you know, she can't walk and chew gum at the same time. You know, she has an IQ too lower than a stone. You know, all of those kinds of things. And it used to drive me a little crazy. I was interested in the issues around me, and I was able to speak out on those issues and wanted to make a difference. I wanted to be a part of change.
I thought the world had changed a little bit when they picked Becky. Well, I had such a chuckle at school because we were all watching it in front of the TV because we thought, here she goes, she's going to win. I think she's going to win.
Many a Miss America has her eye on a fulfilling career, and there are no limits on her choices, from running her own house to running the White House.
This is a presidential election year. If a qualified woman were running for president, how would you feel about voting for her, and why?
If the men candidates running were qualified, I feel I would vote against her. My reasons being that women are very high-strung and emotional people.
Carolyn has blonde hair and blue eyes, and her hobbies are sewing and reading.
versatile green-eyed Joe has worked as a baton-twirling teacher.
If there is any work for me.
We want to push women forward. We want women to realize their whole potential, to be able to be what they want to be, and give them the opportunity and the means to do so.
I'm a paramedic rescue specialist and a trained firefighter.
I presently hold a badge as a deputy sheriff.
Someday I hope to have my own TV talk show.
These girls go on to receive a fine education.
My hope is to one day pursue a challenging career in the field of international law.
Training which, when they return to their communities, enables them to contribute more as teachers.
I intend to pursue a career in elementary education.
As nurses.
I am a 24-year-old registered nurse working in the specialized area of oncology hematology.
As better educated citizens.
As a math major, I may one day design a future space shuttle.
A registered nurse, a veterinarian, a lawyer, a PhD, a medical doctor. These are the women that have competed in this pageant, and some of them have gone on to win Miss America.
From lawmakers to homemakers, Miss Americas have excelled in many fields of endeavor. But not all of them chose their career. Sometimes it chose them.
So here they are. The first runner-up, Joan Mary Agnes, Wisconsin, Miss America, Chocolate Gina, Miss Ohio!
7 years after her reign as Miss America 1963, Jacqueline Mayer's picture-perfect life as a wife and mother suddenly changed.
In 1970, the day after Thanksgiving, I awoke. Kelly, who was 9 months, was crying for a bottle. And I tried to sit up, and I could not sit up. I tried to lift my hand, and it wouldn't lift. I couldn't lift my leg up. And I was terrified, and I just could not believe that I had had a stroke at the age of 28, and how hopeless and helpless I was at that point. All my life, I had done everything that I ever wanted to do, everything that I ever dreamed of, I had accomplished. And all of a sudden, in seemed like one instant, I was paralyzed and without speech and unable to be a person. It took me about 5, 6, 7 years before I felt that I could go out and speak in front of people. I knew that there was a purpose for me to get better, and that purpose was to be able to talk and encourage other people. You can continue to recover and recuperate and get better even after 24 years. I met Jackie in 1991 at a Visiting Nurse Association dinner. Just the previous year, I'd had a stroke. And, you know, they did introduce Jackie as a former Miss America, and I went, uh-huh. Yeah, and then I was watching her face as she was telling her story, and it dawned on me, the last time that I had seen Jackie was about 30 years previous, watching the Miss America pageant in my TV room with my mom. I went upstairs in my bedroom, and before I crawled in the bed, I looked in the mirror and I said, yep, okay, nope, you'll never be a Jackie. And little did I know that, yeah, we might have, in fact, something in common at some point.
Hello, my name is Jacqueline Mayer Townsend, and I understand the devastating blow you have just experienced.
The words that she said really did help me. They really came close to my heart.
I'm not an ideal as a Miss America. I'm the person next door. I'm the daughter. I'm the wife. I'm the person who needs also some encouragement. And I think that being Miss America helps them realize that I am too a human being. I had determination, and I had the courage to say, I know I can do it. And I think we all have to have the courage to say, I know I can do it.
I couldn't believe that she took the time to talk, that she even cared about other people. Because look, she had been a winner before.
Yeah, this was a difficult time for her too, but she was helping me. She was helping me trying to become a winner again.
And that's what I think life is all about helping other people with hope and encouragement and love and support and making their lives a bit better.
For Jacqueline Mayer, something from her past became a source of strength. For Carolyn Sapp, something from her past came back to haunt her.
I kept it very private.
The first runner-up winner,
and I was being threatened,
is Marisol Montalvo, Miss New York.
It was a memory that comes back and it kind of punches you in the stomach.
A new Miss America 1992, Carolyn Suzanne Sapp.
I was crowned Miss America, and the following day, someone had decided to share my private story with the rest of this country, and it was the fact that I had been abused by my boyfriend, my fiancé, and it really hurt me that somebody would think that was so important, and that they were trying to hurt me, my family, but they didn't realize the impact that it would change my life forever, that I would go in a direction and a focus of opening my eyes to the terrible disease that we have here in America, and that's domestic violence. It triggered me. It made me realize that's the same situation that I'm going through, that I was in. With all the clippings that came out on Carolyn, I started saving the ones that had little points here and there that really gave me strength, and I followed her story all through her reign as Miss America. I am in awe that somebody would save clippings, and it humbles me that somebody can gain strength through those. The only result for me is that my pain is small then in comparison to helping someone else.
I too was in an abusive situation, and I was in a very heavy-duty denial stage, and I thought that the shame that goes with being abused is present, and the fact that she didn't deny it really set me aback.
Car started now. We're stuck.
I've never seen anything like this happen before.
Stop laughing.
I said it was an accident.
You sure about that?
Don't! Stop it!
You stop it!
Get away from me!
You want me to leave you alone? Is that what you want?
When I saw her movie, there was a particular scene when Carolyn locked the keys in the car, and her partner was enraged. And I remember a similar situation, or at least it brings back all the car episodes with my husband where I had been thrown out of moving vehicles, I had been tossed to the pavement. It just brought back some really haunting memories.
There's a scene in the movie that I did where I'm almost killed by a knife at my throat.
What do I have to do besides kill myself?
David!
Tell me what?
No.
What?
David!
I have to kill you first, huh?
That was a point when I realized that I could not change the situation and that I needed to get out.
If Carolyn could come forward with the nation watching her and say, yeah, this man did do this to me, then I too can no longer blame myself, but too, I too could step up and say, I'm not to be blamed. I'm a victim here.
I got Carolyn's autograph for my daughter because I wanted her to know that if ever she was in an abusive relationship, that if Miss America could get out of that kind of a relationship, and Miss America giving her mother the strength to get out of that kind of relationship, that she could do it too. Every time somebody comes up to me and they'll tap me on the shoulder, and maybe they'll give me a hug, or maybe they'll just whisper in my ear, I cry. I just can't help it, because it just makes me realize that there's one more person that was helped by this story coming out.
We'll be right back.
continues to change each year, Miss America is truly a reflection of the country she represents. At the end of her year of service, Miss America crowns the new winner. But no Miss America ever really says goodbye. All her life, she'll be Miss America.
And if I touched only a very few lives this year and given them only a brief moment of pleasure and of happiness, then I know that I have achieved the fulfillment which will stay with me forever.
Good night, sweetheart, it's time to go.
Being Miss America is really being involved with people. You travel around the country and you meet people one-on-one.
How could I forget the little blind girl who asked to see Miss America with her fingertips?
Good night, sweetheart, it's time to go.
The little girl with the long blonde ponytail and the big brown eyes who looked up at me and said, I'll practice the piano every single day, Miss America, because you asked me to.
Wait to leave you, I really must say.
I was approached by a little red-headed, freckled-faced boy, and he stood looking at me for a long time, and his eyes kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger, and finally he blurted out, are you her? I shall be ever grateful that the magic that is Miss America touched me.
Next Saturday night, one more Miss America will be crowned. Let's hope she too will be able to reach beyond the crown and touch the lives of those around her. Good night, everybody.